Fucking okay. So what happened? The stream dropped out on the fucking restream's end, and it when I stopped streaming to fix it, and then that to restream said, "Oh, we stopped streaming a stream signal. Better turn off that stream key because it uses a per event stream key." Restream is the worst service I've ever fucking paid for. $20 a month and it does this shit. It's fucking miserable. So yeah, I meant to switch over to something else before this weekend and I just didn't have time. Yeah, I'm not using this service anymore. I'm gonna get my money back at this point because this is... No, I'm replying to chat on both. I replied to you in this chat earlier. Anyways, yeah, this sucks. I'm not using their service anymore, and if you are interested in streaming to more than one service, do not use their service. It's fucking awful. I mean, I am streaming through OBS, but the problem is that, like, OBS natively only supports one destination. You can only stream to one platform. And there is a plugin I've been made aware of that lets you stream to two sources at once, but then you have to run the stream twice. So it's no more network stress. So, I don't know. I'm gonna test that out. I just didn't want to test it out for the first time on this stream. That was sort of a planned thing. Yeah, I'm a little bit frustrated, and that just kind of have the viewer count on YouTube, which sucks, but... Yeah, I'm gonna have to use the multi-RTMP thing, because this is bad. What I was gonna say, right as the stream cut out, is that, at the end of the race, it started playing a Cell Dweller song, but this was like 3 years before his album came out, and like, it was a different version. It was a demo, which I had never heard before. Not even like on like the remastered version of his album with demos on it. So yeah, it was cool. We'll probably pass on doing the second race on this. Yeah, Test Drive Off-Road Wide Open is a fun game. It's very... That's Angel Studios. That is people who became Rockstar San Diego and made the Midnight Club games. So, we have JSRF demo. I have a feeling we're going to run across that on future ones. And also JSRF could be a fun game to play on stream sometime. Max Payne as well. And then Dave Mira. I think we should move on to the next disc. It's been an hour. I think we can move on to the next disc.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to the most exciting.
This was disc 6, if not mistaken.
We'll find out which contestant has come to play.
Anyways, folks, I think we move on to the next round to the next disc available to us. Let me turn the volume down on
the loser dies.
Audio just a bit so we can run this. So we have two options for our next disc. We got disc 8. Right, this was disc 5, I think. We have Disc 8, which is Spider-Man, Crash Bandicoot, and Dreams of Master Chief are the three highlights that I picked off of the disc print. I have not opened the disc yet, so I don't know what's actually in it. Gun Valkyrie, Oddworld, Behind the Game, Superman is Disc 6. So those are the two. I'm going to put the poll up on both platforms. I'm going to start the poll on both platforms. That's the hard thing.
Well, Johnny, tell us who our next contestant is.
Poll. You got polls open on both sites. Six has Spider-Man. How many discs have we done so far? This was the first disc. Yeah, we're gonna pick the pace up a little bit with the next disc. Probably not play a whole Halo demo. Hey, Saturn. Do I have the LucasArts Xbox demo disc? I do not own it, no. I have seen one come through work. But I didn't grab it. Actually, it was sealed, even. I think it's the reason I didn't. So, Twitch is tied, 6-8, because only two people voted. And then YouTube is 64% in favor of disc 8. So I guess we're going for disc 8. And switch that over. I said disc 6 was Spider-Man by accident when I repeated myself, but I was wrong, it is disc 8. But, I mean, it seems like he wanted to bet for Spider-Man anyways in that one, so... Yeah. It was just a one-minute poll. Unless Twitch is behind or something. If people wanted to do Gun Valkyrie, we can change back to the other one. I think I might have made a mistake there. Yeah, I think I got that backwards. Yeah, Burnout 3 is fun. I want to see the dude talk to us again. This is July, so I think the last one was disc 7, this is disc 8. There's the Buffy the Vampire Slayer ad. Perhaps? Music. Oh my god, the music. All right, chat, so what I'll do, since I made a mistake with, like, labeling them on the poll, I'll look at what this one has, and I'll let y'all just give me, like, a yes or no answer on what you want to do, if you want to switch or keep with this one. But I want this trailer to finish, and then I want to see the dude talk to us. That music was incredible. That was fun. Here he is. Here's the man.
You know, last month was a big deal for us because we were finally able to bring the Dead or Alive 3 updater to you, which gives you new costumes for the full game, includes a new movie, and of course has a demo all in one package. It was a great thing, and it's something we want to see more of in the future. So we're talking with publishers and we're talking with developers, trying to get them to do some more of these for different games. What we would like to hear from you is what games you'd like to see expansion packs for and what sort of expansion packs you would like to see, whether it be a new level, a new character, a new weapon for a game, etc. We'll make sure that all of your ideas are considered. On this disc, we've got a few new demos as well as a collection of some classics, and we've got a bunch of new videos. Go over to the features section and see some great original stuff, and of course, we have a ton of new trailers as well, so you can view those in the extra content section. Or you can just check out this video billboard here and continue to watch, and you'll see them eventually. So until the next disc, enjoy yourself, and we'll see you then. Bye-bye.
So an important thing to keep in mind here is that This is before Xbox Live launched. Xbox Live launched in fall of 02. This is July of 02. So they were like going out of their way to make sure like downloadable content happened before DLC was possible on Xbox via these demo discs. And that's kind of neat. They were like talking to publishers and having them do it on the discs instead of having them like downloadable, which is neat. I didn't really think about that as one of the benefits of these discs, but that's really cool. So, yeah. As far as what's on here, we got MotoGP, Spider-Man, Star Wars, Jedi Starfighter, Crash Bandicoot, and Triple Play. There's also top demo picks are from previous months, I'm pretty sure. We got Amped, Bloodwake, PGR1, Rally Sport, and Reckless. I probably don't consider these because they're going to show up on other discs that we have. Features, we've got mocap session for some bike game, another dev commentary for Halo 2, Dreams of Master Chief, which I'm curious about, a first look at Crazy Taxi 3, first look at Robotech, I'm assuming that's Battle Cry. Wow, there's a lot of fucking features on this disc. Okay, another Street Hoops player named Booger. and the extra content, we got Buffy, which we've already seen, these are the trailers. King Lyra, I'm not sure what that's about. This is a Mech Assault trailer, I'm assuming. I'm assuming this is Test Drive Brotherhood of Speed. Yeah, so up to y'all whether or not we switch to the other ones, since I misled you. If you wanted to see the Gun Valkyrie demo, we can do that. If we want to explore this one, it's up to y'all to say yes or no. Yes if you want to stay, and no if you want to switch. Are saying yes. We have one no on YouTube and not a whole lot else going on over there. I want to see this Master Chief stream. That's one of the reasons I picked this disc, was I wanted to know what this Master Chief stream, Dreams of Master Chief thing, was. Have deja vu all of a sudden.
You know our motto, we deliver.
Oh yeah.
Uh-oh. Is this like a Freeman's Mind type deal?
Sir, forgive me for saying, but you look bushwhacked, sir. Perhaps you should get some rest, sir. Don't worry, sir. We'll stand watch. Ain't nothing gonna get near you, sir.
What the fuck is going on?
Perhaps you should take a rest.
Sir, no worries.
I need some music.
Oh my god.
Something to lull me to sleep.
This is giving me secondhand embarrassment.
We've got it covered, sir.
Hello, Joss.
This spot looks good.
Yeah, this is like a really bad Freeman's Mind type deal. Why does he have a gay porn voice? I think you might be rejecting a little bit your own preconceptions.
Hey, nice move there.
We get it. Yeah, that wasn't great. I don't know what that was about. How about some mocap for some dirt bike riding or no fucking way.
You feel that?
I spent my life savings on a good bike that I bought from a friend and just got hooked.
I wasn't expecting to get got by a disturbed down with a sickness jump scare.
It's like freedom, kind of just ride and ride. It's awesome.
That's all I do now, pretty much. Jump and ride street.
Oh, I own this game. I didn't. I kind of forgot the name of it. Yeah, this is the Midway Extreme Sports game label they did. Which was called Midway Asylum.
720s, double truck drivers,
bar spin variations,
couple grinds,
decade air, I tried a double backflip,
540s, flares.
Looking forward to it.
Yeah, I own this. I was gonna get rid of it. I've not played it yet. I was gonna get rid of it, put it in my collection. Maybe I'll stream it sometime. My right ear loves this song. Get a little bit more of the drums on the way out. I'm glad I clicked on that. That was fun. I have that game. Maybe I'll stream it sometime. That looks bad. But the video was cool. Like the actual video going on there is really neat. Let's check out this Crazy Taxi 3 preview.
Someone.
Oh, hey, the menu was in Japanese. That's neat.
Now it's time to burn it up. Crazy Taxi 3.
Hi-Rola. Yeah, I love Crazy Taxi 3. That was a very misleading video, though. That game does not run that smooth. Yeah, a lot of people never played Crazy Taxi 2 or 3, because 3 was OG Xbox exclusive and has never been ported. And 2 was Dreamcast exclusive and only got ported to the fucking PSP. So, those are both really good games. Let's check out this Robotech first look. It doesn't tell us which Robotech game this is. I think it's Battlecry, but there were two on Xbox, so I could be wrong. Yeah, I always thought the mech designs on these games were cool, so I have Robotech Battlecry, but I've not played it. Music's a little underwhelming. I don't think we need to see any of these. Let's check the 10 top players, and we'll play a demo and move on. There's any more Warthog flipping. Did Spider-Man run at 60 FPS on Xbox? Yeah, top play. Smashing Drive, oh my god. If you're not familiar with Smashing Drive, that's something I'll have to show you sometimes. My, old roommates introduced me to it, and it was it's a goddamn trip, man. The music is nonsense. Oh, we get to see more Warthog flip, no way. Yeah, these are definitely just ads. Like, it's just kind of showing off cool shit you can do. Maybe they weren't ads, but, like, they're... Oh, more of this. Okay. Yeah, I probably could harvest that music. Let's play a demo. We got Crash, MotoGP, Spider-Man, Star Wars, Jedi, Starfighter. I think the most unique one here is probably Crash, so let's check that out. And then after this, I motion that we move to the Kiosk disc. Okay, it's a pair of levels. Whoa! Will the demo load as slow as the full release? I mean, if that was it, that didn't seem too bad. This is the part where I admit that I've played Crash Bandicoot, like, twice. And don't really know what I'm doing. So we're gonna... We're gonna get to see that and deal with that. That kills me? How much more crash is here since it's on an actual ZVD? What do you mean? Are you serious? Yeah, I didn't know TNT kills me. But it would give me TNT to use or something. Yeah, I have never played a Crash Bandicoot game for more than 10 minutes. I'll be completely real. These old games sometimes have the entire game on them, old discs. I don't know. I'd be curious to see if that's the case. I mean, I feel like... It really depends on how late the exploits for this were discovered, whether or not they'd do that, because knowing that the Xbox had been hacked, I feel like that would just open up people to launching the whole game. And they would know that. TNT kills instant when spun, but time when jumped on. Well, Nitro doesn't. Looks like. Nitro equals Natachi. Okay. Understood. These games are not something that I've ever really played, and not really my vibe, but I get the appeal. I mean, the jumping on boxes mechanic is fun. Well, Nautical Menace, thank you. I appreciate that. Welcome in. You've caught us in the middle of an Xbox demo disc exhibition. And we are playing a Crash Bandicoot demo after seeing some very 2000s featurettes. Now, I know at least some of the discs I've looked at have G4 TV featurettes on them. I don't think any of the ones we've looked at so far do. But I know that we will have those on... I think the Kiosk disc has a couple, and then I'm pretty sure Exhibition does as well. Welcome back, Harley. Yeah, this seems like a little bit, bare bones, in terms of, soundscape. Like, the background sound effects are very, do you hit the green exclamation marks? Okay, well, okay. I thought that was Nitro, so I did not press it. Yeah, that sure was a crash level. Oh well. Mind-blowing graphics and incredible special effects. The power of the Xbox is... Okay. Well, with that in mind, let's move on to the Kiosk disc, which is probably the most interesting thing we're going to see today, in my opinion. Whether or not its content is as cool as what we're gonna see later on, I don't know. But it's Kiosk time. So, yeah, as far as I'm aware, Celestis, I'm pretty sure the Xbox is in stores
were just regular Xboxes, at least in this era. So, yeah, this disc, I got it through work a while back ago. Ah, victory. Right into it.
Respect. This is XSN Sports. The game has changed forever. Compete like never before. Dominate anyone, anywhere, at any time. Slam, outmaneuver, and crush the competition. Create a league. Enter intense tournament action. Work your way into the XSN Sports Hall of Fame. Real-time statistics are kept. Rankings are updated. Rivalries are born. Check it out on your Bonk. Website and see how you stack up to the competition. Facing a tough opponent? Scout which plays he's run. Find his weaknesses and exploit them. XSN Sports is a whole new level of competition on an unparalleled combination of technologies. Play the games on your Xbox. Hook up with opponents through Xbox Live.
Hook up with opponents?
Results, stats, and rankings on the web using your PC. Even get standings and challenges on your mobile phone. At the heart of it all are the games. Go! All built for online play and real competition. Human competition.
This music.
XSN Sports. Compete beyond the game. It all starts August 2003.
I can't wait. Yeah, one of the unfortunate things about being an OG Xbox fan is that, like, a huge, just because, like, because of the American market, they're aiming for the American core adult market. A huge amount of the marketing and, like, the focus early on, especially, was on sports stuff. So there's a lot of stuff like that. But I don't hate it. It's fun. You get little glimpses into, like, you know, old internet with, like, that clan website they just showed. Yeah, it's cool. So this Kiosk disc, the reason it plays the ad right off the bat full screen is because, like, these things, if I was to sit here and let it time out, which I'm not going to right now, it would show more ads. All of them are available in the videos here, or in these. But it's intended to, like, be on a TV in a store. So if it's not being interacted with, it just plays commercials. So we'll look at demos in a moment, but there are quite a few. Game videos, like I said, we got Amped 2, Crimson Skies, Exhibition Volume 3, which is interesting that they have a commercial. They have on a demo disc, they have an ad for a demo disc. Grab by the Ghoulies, Lynx 04, NBA Inside Drive, NHL Rivals 04, Project Gotham 2, Platinum Hits, an Xbox price drop, Top Spin, an Xbox Live trailer, Xbox Music Mixer, which I want to check that one out. That's the video we just watched, and House of the Dead, movie. This is a movie based on the game, which, Sega was putting House of the Dead on Xbox at this point in time. What I find most interesting about this disc is that there's a lot of stuff that's, like, ads for Xbox services and programs and stuff, rather than specifically games, which I think is really cool. There's more stuff down here, news and reviews, you got, like, G4, this is all G4 TV stuff. So we'll look at that. Xbox Live information, this is a bunch of, like, infomercials about Xbox Live. We're gonna look at all these. ESRB ratings, Microsoft Legal. Yes, there's a lot of stuff reused this sort of format for menus, just because it was they could just modify the XBE. Because I think later demo discs used this, and a lot of, like, the updaters on retail games used this sort of back-end menu. So I think a fun place to start with this, though, is gonna be the Xbox Live ad in here.
because this was Fallout 3. Dark Master. Yeah, I'm very disappointed that I didn't get to experience more of OG Xbox Live as it was new. Mech Assault mention. I also definitely want to see this Xbox music mixer thing. Oh, the font! Yeah, this is probably made in Windows Movie Maker, huh? The PNG of the microphone. Yeah, I honestly, like, if I had any sort of music production skill, I definitely would make some streams of, like, we're using all the weird... Because it's not just this. There was MTV Music Mixer, which had a third game that was on Xbox. I have that. I feel like it could be a really fun thing to make streams doing music production on these. As much as you could, really. I don't think Music Mixer really could as much as MTV. But the Music Maker is, like, a proper DAW to a degree. As proper as an Xbox game from 2003 could be. More interesting ones here are the other Xbox program, like the Platinum Hits program. This one's fun because, like, look at this fucking whack ass text effect they got going on. I've seen this one before. Yeah, the DVD playback kit exists just for license fees. The whole thing was that they didn't have to pay DVD licensing fees for movies, unless you did sell, them the remote. That was like kind of you were paying for the codec license mostly. This is the House of the Dead movie. We'll take a look at that. Did this come out? Like, did this actually happen?
It was a nightmare.
This is a Kiosk disc, Patrick.
Where do you hide? When they're everywhere.
Everywhere.
What do you do? When there's no way out.
Out.
How do you kill?
Kill.
What's already dead.
Dead.
Any way you can.
Like I said,
hang down this week.
It all started a few days ago.
That does sound like Duke Nukem.
Doesn't this bother any of you? We're on the island where the party of the year is supposed to be happening, but it's completely deserted.
Well, they sure as hell did not go to 7-Eleven to get more booze.
What the fuck?
Can't hear anything.
Neither do I.
Run! Run! There must be some kind of scientific explanation for this.
It's not human. It's like it's been mutated.
So, what now?
We send them back to hell.
This is getting DMCA'd. What the hell?
Is that you, Matt?
I just got a DMCA warning on YouTube. Imagine caring about what happens to this.
The House of the Dead.
I've been waiting for you for a long time.
Oh my god, that looked fucking terrible. It was probably the music, but like, fuck, man, that's funny that like of all the things that get us DMCA'd today, it wasn't the Disturbed drums, it was the fucking House of the Dead movie trailer. Exhibition. This is the Xbox demo discs that you could purchase. I have a couple of these. Don't have this one. I think we have it a copy at work though. I should probably buy it. But let's take a look at this. We'll be seeing the volume one of this in a little while. Hold on, so they're advertising this for sale disc that, and they used in the trailer for it. they used a trailer. So a trailer to sell you a disc that part of the reason to buy it is that there's a Halo 2 trailer on the disc, which is very funny. Also, I'm pretty sure that Halo 2 trailer is on at least the first three versions of this disc. Of the exhibition discs. So, that's interesting. I think we can probably skip the trailers for now, just in the interest of time. Like the game trailers. I do want you to show you the Xbox Live info. See the intro video, at least.
Welcome to Xbox Live. I'm Matt, but you're gonna know me online as
Dark Master.
I'm here to tell you all about Xbox Live. The cool thing is that you can play against other gamers everywhere, and there's always somebody online to smash heads against whenever you feel like it. You can play against your friends or make new ones, and there's this communicator thing, so you can trash talk to each other while you're playing games. So really, Xbox Live is a whole new ballgame. It's like plugging an Ethernet cable right into your brain. So I'm gonna help you get going and show you how to plug into the live community. Any questions you have that I don't cover can also be answered by going to xbox.com/live.
Plugging an Ethernet cable
live.
Right into
Let
your
me show
brain.
You some of the cool features Xbox Live built into this amazing service. Come on.
Jump into the arena.
Hey.
I love this visual style.
It's
I'm sorry.
Party in a box. You need two things besides the Xbox to get going with Xbox Live. A high-speed connection and this. This is your Xbox Live starter kit. Inside the starter kit, you get this, the Xbox communicator. Now what's great about this is it lets you talk to other gamers while you're playing. What else? Oh, right, a starter disc with two free games. There's THQ's MotoGP and Microsoft Game Studios Whacked. And here you go, your subscription code.
Scratch here to reveal the number, enter the code.
This is good for 12 months of online gaming.
Remember to scratch and not peel the label.
Score. The starter pack's available at all the same places you go to buy games and Xbox gear. Now when you're at the store, you can spot an Xbox Live game by looking for the Xbox Live logo on the package. The party's on. All that's missing is you.
This shit is super, like, obvious, but also, like, this was brand new, so, like, I understand why they marketed it, because I'm sure, like, it's obvious to us.
Look for a service provider who displays the Xbox-compatible logo.
For more details about internet providers and routers, check out www.xbox.com.
They have an Xbox-compatible verification for ISPs? That's kind of nuts.
You basically have three ways to hook up your Xbox to an internet connection. You got Direct Connect, which is just plugging your cable or DSL modem directly into your Xbox. A Router Connect, if you already have a router set up at home, you just plug your Ethernet cable into the router and the other end into the Xbox.
Now, one important last step. Turn off your modem and router, unplug the power cord for 1 minute, then replug and power up, and your Xbox will automatically configure your system for you.
It's that simple. Now, if your internet provider only offers USB modems, there is one other way to connect, which is to use internet connection sharing through your PC. If you have any questions about your configuration, check out the diagrams in the Quick Start booklet, or again, check xbox.com/live.
Yeah, there was an RCA TV that had like an Xbox compatible deal with it. I can't remember what the
port was called.
And you're ready
to join the Xbox Live community.
But it was a CRT. I had Xbox brand, I guess, as a result. Oh,
sign up for a new account. Start up your Xbox with your live disc loaded.
Ow.
Xbox Live will automatically configure your system. How cool is that? Now you're ready to sign up. Follow the prompts.
I'm allergic to Xbox.
Oh, by the way, when choosing a payment method,
William Jones.
If you have a Visa or MasterCard branded debit card, you may or may not be successful. Non-branded debit cards will not work.
And that's it. The next step is to create your gamer tag. It's your identity on Xbox Live. The legend you build for yourself in this brand new gaming universe. Remember, you're building all your stats and friends in that name. Sign up fast and grab it before anyone else does. Don't just choose anything.
Someone's name was just SSX Tricky.
Next, you'll enter your date of birth. Now we should mention here that you have to be at least 13. Sorry, little dudes. Enter the subscription code and a valid credit card. This is for verification. Don't worry, you've paid for 12 months of the service. If you're a parent, and we know you're out there, Dad, there's some parental protection options you might want to take advantage of. So browse around. You can disable voice, and you can limit charging additional fees to your account. Okay, once you finish sign up, your gamer tag is locked and loaded. You never have to sign up again. You are an official member of the Xbox Live community. On to fame and glory.
Do they show, like... Someone, like, is there low bitrate audio, like, demonstration?
Okay, the Xbox communicator. Plug this little puppy right into here.
Little puppy.
And you're ready for prime time. Put the headset.
Several people just perked up.
Position the microphone like this, about an inch from your mouth. Now, if you're right-eared, like some people, you can remove the earpiece and attach it to the other side.
Right-eared?
You can mute your mic by pressing this button. And you can adjust the volume right here. Okay, now you can talk to anyone you're playing with. Hey, let's call on my buddy, the Honk, to help demonstrate. Hey, yo, Honk.
Hey, what up, Dark?
I've never really
met
the
Honk. That is not
what
that sounds like.
And I can't see him when I play, so I can't really be responsible for how he looks. Hey, listen, you want to help me demonstrate this voice demo, the Honk?
Yeah, no sweat, man.
With the Xbox communicator, Honk and I can talk live like this during gameplay.
Yeah, I can hear him scream when I'm whooping him.
Yeah, you wish. In addition to the muting and volume options, you also have the ability to use voice masking for anonymity, or just pure fun. The Honk here can sound like a little girl if he wants.
You're sick.
Or a robot.
You're twisted.
Or a Dark Lord kind of thing.
Hey, your mom's on the phone.
Okay, obviously trash talking becomes a part of playing Xbox Live games. or you can hook up with your buddies and play as a team. If
yeah, there's nowhere.
And if you don't like what you're hearing, you can mute individual players there's, or all of
this
them.
This is nowhere near.
See ya, hunk.
Yeah, see if you...
The level of low bit rate. I don't know why. I get why, but like I don't know how they got away with that, honestly, because like it does not sound that clear, not even close. Yeah, the voice changer feature is interesting. Was there someone who had their trans awakening using voice masking? Yeah, probably.
One of the best things about Xbox Live is that there are a bunch of different ways for you to find the right game that you're in the mood for at any given time. But first, we got to get signed into the game, which is very simple. With your game loaded, you sign into a game by clicking Play Live. Also, if you have some friends over who are not Xbox Live subscribers, you can have them play along with you as guests. Guests don't have the same privileges as a live subscriber, but they will still have a blast, and you'll want to convince them that they should join the community as well. There are three different matchmaking options. Each one is designed to...
The empty cans of Mountain Dew on the table behind them.
Optimatch and Create Match. Now, if you're looking to hop into a game fast, Quick Match is a great choice. It finds a game with an open slot and drops you in.
The PS3 supported the voice masking.
Whether it's skill level, map, or length of game, Optimatch finds the perfect match for you. With Create a Match, you can start your own game and build a roster based on your friends list. Your choice of game, your choice of players. You will never be without a game to play, anytime, day, or night. Now, does that rule or what?
In theory. Oh, hold on. That, okay, that's NFL Fever. Okay. I was like, that does not look like the friends menu, but I see, yeah, that's NFL Fever. Surely the Dreamcast must have had these. There are Dreamcast demo discs. That's an idea.
Is one of the things I like most about Xbox Live.
They're harder
to
track down.
The Xbox Live console lets you build a friends list.
Yeah, see, if you have friends that have Xbox Live, you can collect their gamer tags and add them to your friends list, or anyone that you're playing against, for that matter.
Well, almost.
To make have at least one of those Sega discs.
Send them an invite, and they
have a Saturn one as well.
Show some respect to your fellow gamers, huh?
Good point. So, what can you do with the friends list? Well, you can see if any of your friends are online and see what game they're playing.
Hey, Dark, why don't you check out what Swami's up to?
Cool. So we're playing MotoGP. I go to my friends list, select Swami, and it shows me he's online and playing Whacked.
Oh, dude, if you jump in there, he will kill you. He shreds you at Whacked, Dark.
Hunky here isn't very good at playing Whacked, you see. So we're gonna invite him to play MotoGP, since we're already playing it anyway. We press invite, and it sends it to him while he's playing Whacked.
He's coming, dude.
Hey, Dark, what's up? I see you're hanging around with the emotionally challenged again.
Hey, what's up, my man?
Word, salami.
You know, it is a good day to die, cheesemaker.
I can smell your feet all the way out here in Wisconsin, salami.
Okay.
Jesus
you
Christ.
You ready to get creamed? Now, check this out. When you jump into a game, Xbox Live shows your players list. You see who's in the game, who's a friend, and who has a voice communicator. In some games, the players list will also show you player stats.
Get your butt in here, Dark!
Okay, well, there's a lot of cool things in the next section, too. Maybe you should go check those out.
So, another funny thing about this is that MotoGP didn't have Xbox Live support. There was a demo version that came with the Xbox Live, some of the Xbox Live starter sets that did. So it's kind of interesting to see them using that so hard to market, but this, you know, this is probably shot right when they first... started. See Namco MotoGP? Yeah, that was Namco, I'm pretty sure. Am I wrong? Ah, the you try to scroll further than you're supposed to. That's always very fun. One more of these.
Hey, did you know that your Xbox has a Mondo hard drive? This means that game updates can be sent to you right over the network and stored on your hard drive. Say, like, current roster changes in your favorite sports games, new vehicles, maps, weapons, racetracks, skins, a ton of stuff. It's huge. I just go to the list of downloadable content, choose what I want, and pop it up onto my Xbox. Good to go. Downloaded content keeps every game fresh. Oh, hey, look who's back. Hunk, how's the weather in Wisconsin?
I don't know. I'm in Florida on vacation at my uncle's house.
Really? But you're playing off your same old account. I can see your stats and everything. How'd you do that?
With my handy Xbox memory unit, of course. They sell it separately, but it's totally worth it. My memory unit lets me take my gamer tag wherever I go.
So you can roam around anywhere in the country with that thing?
Yeah, but as long as you have a friend who has an Xbox Live rig connected to a high-speed internet connection, you can.
Impressive. I'll have to pick me up one of those. Hey, so Hunky, is there
a friend? Okay, got it.
No. But I can talk about cheese if you want.
I don't think so. All right, so there you go. Plenty to work with. You have your Xbox Live gear. You have the quick start manual. You have the online address, xbox.com/live. And hey, what more could you want? Enjoy the game.
Yeah, so Celestis, the account recovery, if I'm not mistaken, it was like a little bit more complicated back then. You had to have like your credit card number, or if you didn't have a credit card and filed, like, it was your subscription code. Maybe that was, I don't know, but it was a lot more complex. It wasn't a username and password like it was on the 360. Also, if I'm not mistaken, if you recover your account, it stops working elsewhere. So it's a little bit different. Hello, McLaren. I do want to see one last thing before we move into the demos, is ESRB ratings. I want to see if this is a silly video. I will hydrate.
Sports, you gotta play the game that's right for you.
Derek Jeter!
Same with computer and video games. That's why parents should make sure each game is right for their kids. How? Check the rating. Every game box has a rating symbol that suggests what age the game is best for, and a content label that tells you what's in the game. When you check the rating, you know what to expect. See? You gotta play the game that's right for you.
Fun. Okay. Let's check out... There's G4 demos on there, but we're kind of running out of time. So we got a few games. I kind of want to do one demo from these, maybe two, and then move on. So we got Grabbed by the Ghoulies. We got, you know, tons of sports games. Disney's Extreme Skate Adventure. Which is a fun one. Prince of Persia 4, Soul Calibur 2, Tiger Woods 04, Voodoo Vents, and Wrath Unleashed. If y'all have thoughts, I'd love to hear them. I personally am leaning towards doing at least Disney Skate Adventure. And there's anything else someone wants to see? RVB videos, I know that was a common theme when I was looking through demo discs. I don't think so. Not in this one. This was pretty early in what the fuck is this, like, what the fuck? Let's see the about PG 4 thing.
Get into the game like never before.
If you're watching this, you're watching G4 TV, and if you're not, then you're asleep and no one knows.
Get the lowdown on the latest hype from the only network dedicated to video games.
Rez mentioned.
Invade your television with the hottest adrenaline pumping, bone cracking.
It's weird. This is like a. Find anywhere else. Was that Dave Grohl? I don't think so. With 13 original was it? Series,
for gamers by gamers.
Hi, I'm Bill Sindelar, and welcome to Blister.
G4 goes behind the
scenes. Oh, is there going to get Tommy Tallarico mentioned?
Scratching. It's the same type of energy as releasing your soul through just having fun.
To bring you the insider information that no gamer should be without.
He walked up to me and was like, you want to be a video game? And I was like, yeah, but it's got to be really cool.
With up-to-the-minute news and reviews.
You've got a game, we've got a way to crack it.
This is one of the best platform games ever made.
There he is!
Play this game.
You'll never...
Tommy Tallarico.
Oh, Lord.
From the beach to the video arcade.
So we're taking these hardcore gamers and we're matching them up with the model.
What would you say is your strategy?
Throttle them until they cry.
To the depths of cyberspace.
In real life, it hurts when a girl slaps you in the face. But in virtual life, there's another
high. Oh my god.
Just down the road.
G4 doesn't just take you to the game.
Let the games begin!
Tonight, we'll see if our current champion can hold their own against the challengers.
They put you in the game.
Head over to the website. You can recommend what games we play, who we talk to on the show.
Each week, we bring it to life.
We all dream of being NBA players. It's our chance to be NBA players today.
Your vote counts.
Unreal.
And that's not all.
Yo, what's up? This is Coolio with the flow. Keep your eyes.
Coolio. Next episode of Players. Need just die you like recently. You go behind closed
doors. I'm actually in the Madden 2002.
You're in it?
Yeah.
That's so cool.
To find out who's playing what.
We play this game 5 hours a day.
Well, you can never have enough gore.
Marilyn Manson. Hello.
This is Tony Hawk. What's up, y'all? We are the Executioners.
This is Pink.
Executioners. Okay. Tony Hawk.
I'm a player.
Yeah.
Then get into the game.
I'm glad we checked this out. I was kind of thinking about skipping all the G4 stuff, but I'm glad we checked this out. I am curious what these have at Dino Crisis 3. I don't really want to watch a whole review. It's fun. That's fun. Yeah, I don't want to watch a whole review, but I am curious, so we'll have to watch that off stream sometime, Harley. Let's do the Disney Skate, and then we got another one to two discs to get through today, so maybe we'll do one more, depending on how much time this takes us.
I don't wanna be told to go.
Activision is here today to cast 10 real kids into our new skateboarding video game, Disney's Extreme Skate Adventure.
Please make me, please.
I plan on ripping and uploading these. As far as I'm aware, they're already uploaded. Neversoft made that? No. Sort of. This is a reskin, essentially, of Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 4. It is technically under the skin, it's Neversoft. But no, this is a different developer essentially making a sanctioned mod for Pro Skater 4. It's Pro Skater 4, Beatman. It uses a lot of the same assets as Pro Skater 4. Maybe it has a little bit more in Thug, but I'm pretty sure it's a. I'm pretty sure it is mostly Pro Skater 4 stuff. Which version does it say the front of the disc? This is 3.2. Yeah, I remember checking this one. It has been backed up, as far as I'm aware. Throws us right in. Let's turn that down. This throws us right into a character selects menu. Not available to know. I can't play as Tantor, Tarzan, Buzz Lightyear, Woody, Timon and Pumbaa, Simba, or these two actual children. I will be these actual children. Oh, the stats are... Okay, they're not maxed. Never mind. The stats are all the same for the kids, but then they're higher on the real characters. Actual real children. You can... We can make a fucking character. I didn't know this was a thing. Like, I've played this game, but I didn't know this existed. I take the helmet off. New Liberty spikes on a child. Hell yeah. I want this child to get injured if they fall off. Friendship bracelet. I'm skating flip-flops. Forest camo pants, naturally. None of those. What shoes options? Okay. Pause? It goes from fine to, like, unsettling the larger it gets. Barking robots. I know a few of those. This is kind of just like, yeah, kid version of my thug character, huh? Permanent pog face. Hi, Hoot. Oh.
That was so rad.
Oh no, they're voiced. Oh yeah, I need to turn off the turn on the pro controls, otherwise this feels like shit. Yeah, this is sort of just you can see it's just Pro Skater. And if you turn the pro controls on, it plays like Pro Skater. Otherwise, it has like really simplified controls and doesn't let you do as much. And, you know, I also smell an amount of DBCA, but honestly, maybe not. The reverts are slow.
My men have constructed a domino race course. To complete your skate training, make it through the domino gates in the allotted time.
Oh yeah, I guess I have kind of covered this game, huh? First gate.
Another gate has been completed. Keep going.
This child is so large. I regret this.
Almost completed this course, superior racing soldier. You are one gate away from completion. Good work, soldier.
Cool. It's so much slower. Maybe it's the scale of the level, but it feels very slow. This is a... It's basically just Pro Skater 4, but worse, and, I don't know. Can I grind that? Like, can I grind the loop? Maybe, in theory? Maybe not. Kind of boring that you can't.
That was so rad. Cool!
That's the game. That's that game. There's not a whole lot to see. If you've played the game, it's kind of this, it's, I think this is a post-release demo. Oh, XSN. Okay. Yep. Yeah, Kiostis. This is a neat little thing. Is there a Microsoft? This is... Okay, that's just a copy. Yeah. Yes, this is cool. I definitely want to explore more of those. Today I just sort of wanted to do a all my real discs, or at least some of my real discs. And that might be remain the case for a while. But once I get through the interesting discs that I have, I'm not opposed to doing streams where I curate some more rare and hard-to-find discs. Because the Kiosk discs are definitely the most interesting ones in my opinion. So, anyways, I think what we're going to do, because we have about an hour left in what I was allotted for the stream today. Demo disc Megamix stream? Possibly. The only thing is that, like, if I'm doing real hardware, which I like to keep it that way, the concern there does become the logistics of changing consoles during the stream. So, if anything, I would say maybe two consoles is the max I want to do in one stream, because I could take a little intermission and switch over off camera midway through. But yeah, I think what we'll do for the rest of today is switch over to the Exhibition Volume 1 disc. Just because it's the first one, it's from 2002. Although it could be interesting, you know, I might call an audible real quick. I might do a later demo disc, because I know I've done... Everything we've done today has been from 2002 or 2003. And I'm kind of wondering if maybe I should do something late. So I have a couple of options if we want to do that. What do y'all feel? Do y'all want to do another 2002 or 2003 disc? Or would you want to go over to something like 2005? Looks like YouTube chat is in favor of 2005. Okay, I've got a couple options in that case. We got... one from June 06. Which has both Xbox and 360 content on it. We have a Holiday 05 release, which has the cover is King Kong. It's got like Battlefield 2 Modern Combat, Serious Sam 2, Evil Dead, some 360 trailers. And then I have one from February 05. It has 7 demos, 3 Xbox Live-enabled playable demos, which is interesting. Yeah, this is it's got Republic Commando on the cover. It does have Mech Assault 2. Ghost Recon 2, Great Hastings Tournament Paintball. There's a hidden demo. So yeah, there's a few other options here. Do we want to do the 06 one, or do we want to do the... that has, like, 360 content, but less Xbox content? Or do we want to do the February 05 with live-enabled demos? I can just start polls on both places. What I'll do is I'll put the polls on both places. And then I'm going to take a bathroom break. I'll put a video on while I'm gone. And let y'all hash that out. Three-minute poll. Both places. Start and start. Poll is running on both Twitch and YouTube. Take a look at the top of the chat box to vote. And let's put a video on. All right, chat. I'm going to use the restroom. Watch my Xbox for me. Make sure no one knocks it over.
Let's head to the cosmos for a look at Dino Crisis 3. That's right. We are headed to outer space with a dinosaur game. Think of the third game in the survival horror series as a hybrid of Jurassic Park and Alien. But Sigourney Weaver ain't going to save you this time. Put away your books on paleontology and archaeology. Ditch those lectures on evolutionary theory and natural science. And definitely get rid of those romance novels. For it is I who have discovered the truth about the sudden disappearance of dinosaurs. It wasn't a giant rock from outer space slamming into the earth that made the dinosaurs go the way of the dodo. It was space travel. The dinos simply learned how to fly. Well, it was either that or they just couldn't sit through the second and third Jurassic Park movies.
Enter Patrick. He and his team are sent out into space in the year 2548 to investigate an enormous ship that has appeared out of nowhere. Of course, things go foobar for Patrick, and he's left alone on the ship along with hundreds, nay, thousands of dinosaurs. Where did the ship come from? What happened to the original crew? And why, for the love of Pete, are the dinosaurs roaming the quiet countryside?
We haven't given away too much for the storyline yet with Dino Crisis 3, but I can tell you the setting is in space.
Thank you.
And it's a gigantic ship that can transform, and the environments on this ship are unbelievable. They're the biggest environments I've ever seen. All the dinosaurs on the ship are mutated, and there's quite a decent variety of them.
The first two games for the PlayStation were more like Capcom's Resident Evil series, with the nasty dinos taking the place of zombies. This Xbox-exclusive Dino 3-quel is not only in full 3D, but it also boasts a few other improvements, namely, faster action. Patrick has a healthy supply of...
Alright, I'm back. Hello.
...that attack the dinosaurs, an auto-targeting system, a first-person mode, and a jetpack.
You can use your jetpack to not only get to higher places, but you can zip across the screen and get away from...
How are they feeling about Dino Crisis 3 in this video?
Personally, I like the spaceship flying dinosaur theory the best. It doesn't take much of an imagination to tell people that the dinosaurs are extinct because of a rogue asteroid. But a couple of dinosaurs named Maverick and Goose, I'm so there.
Visually, I guarantee.
Yeah, so something I've realized, Badger, from watching G4 a little bit more. Especially, I watched a lot last year with my roommates just because it was a fun little thing to throw on that didn't matter. Night, Jess. Is that G4 wasn't very good. All right, so we got 80% 2005 votes out of 18 votes, or 77% 2005 votes out of 18 votes on YouTube. Twitch voted 2006, but only 4 people voted and 3 of them voted 06. It looks to me like the 05 demo is the higher portion of people across both streams. Just because YouTube's got more people voting. So we'll do the 05 one. The 06 one I'll revisit whenever I do 360 demos. So that the 360 demos are gonna happen probably next. Honestly, I think to give myself a little bit of a break before doing another OG Xbox One, I'll probably do some 360 demo discs soon. So yeah, let's check out this 2005 Xbox demo disc. This crystal Xbox is very well, it's in very good condition. I think I'm having a little problems with the start button, the power button on the front of the console, but I think maybe it might just not have been used much because it feels like it's very stiff, but like in a, like a brand new kind of way.
7 days ago,
and there are no saves on the box. There was like a save for Dead or Alive 3. How was that?
Where exactly on the ice is this?
This is an ad for a movie?
It's 2,000 feet under it. Let's make history.
Oh, AVP.
Whoever built this pyramid believed in ritual sacrifice.
Yeah, G4 was very racist and sexist as well, unfortunately.
What was that thing? What's going on?
What did you say this room was called?
Sacrificial chamber.
This story's all here. This whole thing was a trap.
They're not hunting us.
The 46th one has a Nin music video? What the fuck? What song? That's like Year Zero era, right? No, this is 41. Yeah, so that would be with Keith. That makes sense. I need that. This looks bad. This era was like the dark era of like sci-fi horror. I feel like everything back then was awful. Whoever wins, we lose is definitely a hard tagline. Gotta say that though. Oh. Okay, it's the same 3D menu, but like flipped and rearranged a little bit. And 7 days ago, different. Okay, yeah, it's the same sort of concept, but it's a little bit different. Discovered a pyramid. Different sounds. Also, why is it playing the same thing?
Where exactly on the ice is this?
It's not on the ice. It's 2,000 feet under it.
Oh, the same guy from before. Gary Cribb. Gary Cribb looks like Chino Moreno. Digital Eclipse did these. Interesting. Who's Nile Rodgers? Double fine. Wow, the zoom in makes it a little bit bigger, but then it's also at an angle.
A 3-pound pile of trees. This is
this Psychonauts? Yeah.
And this is your landing craft.
At a unique summer camp for the paranormally gifted.
Don't you train Psychonauts here?
That is what I wrote on the pamphlet.
Young cadets are taught to perfect their powers.
Now get in here and give me 20.
And the counselors.
What a delightfully mean little brain you have. Just what we want.
Have secrets to hide.
When you just give me my lab for some experiments, I'm sure he could withstand more than the others.
I've got big plans for that mind.
My name.
Air 51 demo, Brothers in Arms, Far Cry, Oddworld, Psychonauts.
I have a chance to be something. Make a difference.
Area 51 is something I want to look at one day.
We're gonna have to remove your brain and make it shoot down innocent civilians with its concentrated psychic death beam.
Iron Phoenix?
Is that your insurance is gonna cover the whole thing.
Sammy Studios became,
an army of psychic death tanks to take over the world, and there's no one who can stop.
Yeah, Area 51 got a sequel called Black Sight Area 51 on 360. I actually got that recently for like $3. Iron Phoenix, so Sammy Studios became High Moon.
And win her heart.
PNGs! Yeah, it looks like an original Xbox fantasy game. What's like the word for this particular subgenre of fantasy that like a ton of OG Xbox games had, where it was like that sort of edgy Mortal Kombat-esque like style of armor and like move sets and stuff.
the name Iron Phoenix comes from the background story.
I love this dude's muffled, very quiet, poorly mixed microphone.
The aura of the meteor is discovered by this blacksmith, and he uses the aura of the meteor to create these 9 weapons. We take a lot of...
Oh, this got canceled?
...and incorporated them into some of our own mythology. And we tried to basically also build a setting that was itself alive. So we tried to give these backstories to the weapons. That on the disc, you'll be able to view these brilliantly animated kind of sequences of the history of all the weapons and how they're passed through time and how they go from the hands of one warrior to another, or from people that aren't even warriors to another. There's a lot of little love stories, and there's a lot of little action sequences and stuff like that that really, I think, bring to life the backgrounds of the weapons.
I've seen ads for that cover, for that game before, like the cover art. I didn't realize that game ever came out. That's cool.
It's a large, heavy sword, and the heavier weapons in Iron Phoenix require a little bit more of finesse and timing. We also have the Phoenix Talons, which are a small...
Oh, that Bourne game. ...type weapon. They probably would have made a lot more money off of this. The Bourne game was ass.
One-on-one melee, kind of, you have to get in really close. So your strategy changes with what weapon you use. The Searing Dagger is a fast attack weapon. A lot of the moves with the Searing Dagger involve leaping around people and dodging attacks and then coming in for like a...
Man, the people who edited these interviews were not nice to the people who they interviewed. They didn't like cut out where they misspoke or stammered. They didn't like, I don't know.
Allows you to go in and attack your enemies.
It makes it kind of like hard to watch too.
It's really great for going up against enemies that are using short range weapons like the Talon or the Dagger.
So is this like a Soul Calibur style like head-to-head fighting game? No, it's got an arena with their characters in it. Lame text is interesting.
The game here, you can tell that these environments are...
Player.
They're fairly large. And this environment here is about medium size. It's probably made to accommodate anywhere between 8 to 10 players. I can run along the walls. And that's one of the coolest features in Iron Phoenix, is being able to run on any of the walls. I just picked up that blue orb. That's chi power up. As you see here, you can see in the top of my my screen here that you can see now that my chi bar is glowing. That means that I can perform a lethal strike.
Yeah, I kind of sort of seen this game's cover somewhere before, and I maybe it was ads.
And sit down and just mash buttons and have a lot of.
Well, Feature Studios, I feel like, was the. Publisher? It was released, okay. I guess I'm not insane in misremembering. Okay, that's it for real this time. Windows Movie Maker ass bullshit. Okay. Oh, that's right. So this one, it said on the box, it had a Halo 2 audio track. Hear more of the Halo 2 original soundtrack, which is composed by Martin O'Donnell and Mike Slavitt. Totally features new music by Incubus, Hoobastank, Brinking Benjamin, Nile Rodgers, and... Nataraj? Go to NileRodgers.com. What's here? Hell yeah. Hey, Anne. Thank you. Lay down. Enjoy rest. I swear to God, this mix is different. There's no way that it had that obnoxious of panning in the beginning on the original version. I've been linked to NileRodgers.com about biography. Ah! I just got jump scared by that. I didn't realize it was gonna autoplay loud audio. Y'all remember downloading this for Guitar Hero 3 and playing this in Guitar Hero 3 on 360? I do.
Oh, this is a Full Spectrum Warrior bonus level. Oh, you have to have played the game before you can copy the content. Okay, that's good to know. If I ever play the game, I will. Huh? Oh. Going back to the main menu starts the EVP trailer over again. Alright, playable demos. We've got a few. Oh yeah, there's a demo for Iron Phoenix right here. Mech Assault 2, Republic Commando, Ghost Recon 2, FIFA 05, Greg Hastings. It's not on the ice. It's 2000. I want to know how to get the secret demo.
Let's make history.
What was the special guest star appearance? Was there someone in this that I didn't remember? Did I miss that? I feel like that's gotta be where the secret demo is, right?
At a unique summer camp for the paranormally gifted.
Don't you train psychonauts here?
That is what I wrote on the pamphlet.
Young cadets are pressing all the buttons.
Get in here and give me 20.
Okay, so if you press black, it does this.
Just what we want.
Have secrets to hide.
If I could just get him in my lab for some experiments, I'm sure he could withstand more than the others.
I've got big plans for that mind.
It's cool, because like I know that like the OG Xbox menu is fully rendered. Like, it's fully 3D and rendered on the console. As is the boot up animation. It's really interesting that they still did that for the demo discs and like let you fly around them like this. That's really cool. It looks really nice. I love shit like this. This is demo disc 41, I think.
Save his friends.
Don't worry. I know where your brains are.
Yeah, I'm I don't really know.
And win her
Nope, no MVP. back, white, left, X, Y, up, down, A, black, B, right, start. Oh, hold left trigger while doing it. Okay. Back. White, left, X, Y, up, down, A, black, B, right, start. Is that this? Is that what we're looking at? No. Surely not. This is Far Cry. Okay, maybe because I wasn't in that already. Alright. Left trigger. Back, white, left, X, Y, up, down, A, black, B, right, start. I heard a noise. Did that do that? No? Okay, so I want you to know that I knew I was on the right track there, because I held left trigger, I go back, it starts vibrating a little bit, back again, every button press, it starts vibrating more intensely. Oh, did it, okay. Like, it gets gradually more intense in vibration until it's, like, fucking shaking full speed before the last button press. Attack 2. Sure is. That avalanche? Like, the Just Cause people? Watch the trailer. I kind of want to check out some of the other demos on here.
The step of dreams. It's
magic is legendary. Its force can be lethal. Now only one young hero can use its power to save the world.
Oh, there's two Avalanche studios? Okay.
Staff of Dreams, the video game, in stores this October.
I thrifted a GameCube copy of this game like 15 years ago, and I bought it because it was $2 and never played it. It's not an aesthetic or theme that really appeals to me at all. It is cool that there's a secret demo. I wonder how many of these had that.
7 days ago,
I think it would be cool to see the live enabled demos. I wonder
where exactly on the ice is this?
It's not on the ice. It's 2000.
I wonder if once Insignia adds support for any of these games. I don't think it has yet. Maybe Iron Phoenix does. I wonder if the online portions of the demos would work.
Pyramid believed in ritual sacrifice.
Let's check out the Republic Commander demo. That's like the really cool one on this disc, in my opinion. There we go. Difficulty settings is really cool to see in a demo. Bubble, you know? Interesting. So it's not the on the surface Geonosis levels. It's the one in the ship. There's like a weird amount of input lag. Maybe it was always like this, but I've not played the Xbox version of this game in a long time. Yeah, this game did not run great on Xbox. I remember that much. It was a bit of a framey mess at times. We're not gonna play this whole demo, but it is cool. I was hoping there'd be a bit more unique about it. I always love when the when demos have like unique levels and stuff. Ow. Bloody scream! So real. Yeah, this is really framey. Was this game out yet? Like, was this game out in early 05? I thought this game was like a fall 05 release. Because I wonder if this is pre-release, that would explain the frame rate.
Complete, ready for war.
Well done, 3-8. There's a loading substation somewhere on.
March 05, so this was right when it was coming out.
Let's get to it, Deltas.
Yeah, I can see this being a little bit prior to launch because the frame rate is not quite there. Maybe it is this bad in final release, but I do not remember it being this laggy. Also, that guy's having a good time.
Take them out from there, Delta.
What's that?
It's a droid defense, 07. Next time, read the briefing.
This game is really good. I really need to like finish it. I never did. I got to the last third of the game, but I just never finished that part of it.
Good work, squad. I hope we don't run across more of those anytime soon.
Initiate door breach, Commander.
I hear noise.
Squad mechanics are really cool.
Setting charge. Clear!
Oh, the fucking sensitivity and the frame rate. Like, it's like the sensitivity... I don't know how to describe other than when the frame rate hitches, the sensitivity seems to, like, not slow down with the game. Aim the fucking swing all over the place. I hate these things. I remember these things being such a pain in the dick. The remaster had bad performance? I don't remember that from what I played of it. I again didn't finish it, but...
around here somewhere. Let's get to it, Deltas.
Okay, there's a bug. Not playing the sound consistently. The sound sounds different. Yeah, it's a different sound for the fiber blade. I also feel like the color on the arm was a little bit different in final version. Oh, that could be memory. Yeah, that's absolutely a different vibroblade sound effect.
Back to Jenkins.
Interesting.
I feel better now.
Sir, get going.
Where is this terminal? Here it is. We're not gonna finish this, just because there's other stuff I want to take a look at. But yeah, this is cool. It's cool that it's got a little bit of differences and like pre-release issues. Kind of cool to see. Yeah, I played the Republic Commando remaster on PS4 and had an okay time with it. Yeah, the Battlefront collection is something. let's check out Mech Assault 2, because I've never played it. And it's live enabled. I wonder if there is single player content. Oh. Okay, yeah, it is single player. It's... Why did it bring us to a separate menu with that one option? Bit of a head scratcher. Okay. Yeah, maybe it's something to do. I'll have to look at one of the other live enabled demos and see if it does the same thing. Huh? You walk around in the main menu? I love smell divers too. Now this is inverted for some reason. I love Helldivers too. This is interesting looking. I've never seen this game. Yeah, I mean, I know of it, but I've never played it. Or watched anybody play it.
Okay, listen up, Mech Warrior. Mechs are the key to winning any war. The more we get and the less they have, the better. I have an idea for a lesson in audacity. I'm going to drop you in a prototype battle armor right inside the enemy base. You're going to grab a mech and walk it back. Repeat as needed. Sound good?
I'm reading support vehicles, as well as active mechs. You won't be able to steal all of them.
So is this game of on-foot sections? Is that a thing in the first game?
Drop you on the ridge on the west side of the base. To detach from the VTOL, just activate your jump jets.
You should be able to use your mortar to take the enemy out from this ridge, then go down and steal a mech. Sir, I added a really cool feature into the battle armor. Jump jet near an enemy mech and use your claw to latch on. It'll bring up the NeuroHack interface.
This is cool. This feels a lot better than what I played in Mech Assault 1. Looks pretty damn good too. Something in my right ear is pulsing, like a warning siren. My health going down, but I don't really know how to... Okay. I guess that bar on the right's my health?
Mechs are the key to winning any war. The more we get and the less they have, the better. I have an idea for a lesson in audacity. I'm going to drop you in a prototype battle armor right inside the enemy base. You're going to grab a mech and walk it back. Repeat as needed. Sound good? All right. I'm going to drop you on the ridge on the west side of the base. To detach from the VTOL, just activate your jump jets.
You should be able to use your mortar to take the enemy out from this ridge, then go down and steal a mech. Sir, I added a really cool feature into the battle armor. Jump jet near an enemy mech and use your claw to latch on. It'll bring up the NeuroHack interface.
Starting again. I've received my lesson on audacity. Can I go home now? Holy shit, he ate the mortar. This heals me, right? I guess not. What was the... What did it tell me to do? Did you do this? Yeah. There we go.
We have hostile forces stealing mechs. I repeat, hostile forces stealing mechs.
Hotshot, get that mech back to the Icarus so we can get a better paint job.
Oh, new metal guitar. New metal bass line, rather. Got mechs and new metal? I'm fucking in.
Good job, sir. We'll need all the weapons we can get. That's one. Hop on and I'll get you back out there. And you might not have to destroy all the defenders. We're just here for the mechs. Your call.
What's the battle armor? Oh, there's more battle armor. Okay, cool.
On the way to the eastern side of the base.
Yeah, I think I'll end up playing this game at some point. This is fun. Yeah, I know that this isn't on Insignia yet, just because it uses, like, this is one of the games that uses basically every Xbox Live feature. It's like Halo 2 and Forza and this. You use, like, the clans feature and all that shit. That said, Halo 2 was kind of, like, the impetus for that. Like, that was, like, the one where they were gonna get everything working with it, and then they got Forza working immediately after, so I have a pretty strong suspicion that in a week or two we're gonna see this launching on Insignia. This is probably serendipitous timing that I'm getting interested in it. Oh shit. The building collapsed too. It got me. Does that start the whole level over?
Okay, listen up, Mech Warrior.
Yeah, it does.
Mechs are the key to winning any war. The more
we'll call that one there. But yeah, that's really cool. I think I'll probably check out that game in my spare time. That's fun. That has me in the mood to play a lot more OG Xbox like single player games. Cause I feel like lately I've really only been playing shit that's on Insignia, but I'm into this. I'm very into this. Also, maybe you want to play a test drive off-road again. Wow, a demo did its job of selling you on a game. I mean, okay. In fairness, the game I've had the game for like 6 years, and I got it at a thrift store for $3. So, I probably wouldn't go out and purchase the game at a store for $60 off of that demo. But I mean, hey, if I want to live that 2005 life for real, I mean, I guess that's what I'm doing right now. Let's try the Iron Phoenix demo to see if it does that thing.
7 days ago, one of my satellites opened.
If it brings me that second 2D menu the way that the yeah, it's gotta be something with the live integration. Can I get you a copy of the game for $3? I mean, I'm happy to send you an NTSC copy of the game. Next time one comes through my job, I'll grab it for you. I'll need to send you all those Saturn games. Someone gave me a copy of this recently. One of my satellites over in Antarctica. Hey, Red Dog. Someone gave me a copy of this recently. It's scratched to shit. I don't think it's gonna work. But this is an Xbox exclusive, weirdly enough. Like, there are games on PS2 that are in this series, but this first one is apparently an Xbox exclusive, which I think is interesting. I remember them not being very good, the paintball games that I played. But maybe I'm wrong. I know that they have their fans. That is interesting. The background video's not quite smooth. Sorry, did that say that the... Okay, it's reversed. Wow, that graphic is terrible. I thought it was telling me that right trigger was shoot, or left trigger was shoot. Yeah, it's fine, let's just play it. Freaks of Nature is the other team. Oh, I have played this, like, not that long ago, I don't think. Oh, the graph, the field of view, the massive. Turbo is how you sprint, you press Y to activate sprint mode. Battlefield 2 Modern Combat moment, what the fuck? Yeah, this looks like shit. As I understand it, though, this game had like a pretty active Xbox Live scene. Is there another player left? Free look. Interesting. That's my teammate. The flag was grabbed. What? Oh, okay. So they were all eliminated. We had to grab the flag. Got it. I like that they have this game that's set up around like serious competitive paintball. And then they, like, build a mechanic into the core of it that's cheating. Got him. Where's the flag? I mean, okay, I can totally see this being fun. Where's the flag? I can totally see this being fun online, actually. I'll give them that. I wonder what the other ones play like, if they're any better. Don't see the flag. Do I have it? Is that the flag? That's the flag. Would not call this self-explanatory.
Excellent.
There we go. I guess that's our... We started over there, but okay. Paintball. We're paintballing. Okay, I think we've kind of seen what this demo disc has to offer, short of playing a couple more games. But I think, you know, we have, it's been 3 hours. We have, I think I got half an hour or so left in me. I run this a little bit longer. I think we'll look at that disc that we originally planned to, the exhibition one. And the main reason I'm doing that is that I know that there's stuff on there that we've already seen on the other discs because they were on, the other discs that were not, sold at retail. And, you know, there's a little bit more to look at. Plus, Exhibition 1, I feel like on future trips, we won't be looking at Exhibition 1 because it's O2. We've already done so much O2 stuff. So, let's get stuff. For the sake of rounding out everything I said we were going to do today, let's go and do that one. My headphones just came unplugged. I didn't realize for like several seconds. So, I guess I'm not hearing AVP, so that's maybe a good thing. I'll explain what the exhibition disc is in a little more detail when I return.
What did you say this room was called?
Sacrificial chamber. This door.
Okay, so exhibition discs for Xbox, the whole idea was that you would pay $8 was the retail price on them in America. I don't know about elsewhere, but if they had them elsewhere at all. But they were in Xbox retail game boxes. And they were just like a bit of demos and extras and stuff. There were 6 of them, I believe. Oh. Oh. Okay. Interesting. This reminds me, I kind of forgot about this while planning this stream. I have an Xbox CD. Yeah, it cuts out. That's interesting. I have an, oh, dismemberment plan. The D plan. What a... When you don't have enough room to fit it in, you just have to call it the D plan, dismemberment plan. I actually do know that band. That band's good. That's Capricuti, obviously, I know. I don't know the rest of them. Indie Electronica, though. I mean, hey, that's interesting. I'm not going to play any of these. Where does this come from again? They were sold at retail. You'd buy them in game stores. They were $8 releases. Yeah, you got some music. Cool. I got videos here. So you got Blink's trailer, Brute Force trailer. Some more G4 stuff. That's G4 ad. G4 on E3. G4 on volleyball. Just DOA bought volleyball. Oh God, do we want to subject ourselves to this? Actually, all right, let's find it. I'm probably gonna regret this. You know, I think I actually watched this segment on TV not too long ago, like on YouTube.
The fighting game Dead or Alive 3 is still one of the most beautiful games on any system, and not just because you get to play as girls like Christie and Hitomi, women who look like models but fight like Bruce Lee. Weather effects, huge breakable levels, and tons of detail are just some of the things you can say about this game when you're not distracted.
Is this background partially CGI? What's going on? This looks fucking unreal. Of a sunny island for a little non-violent Xbox action in the form of some extreme volleyball. Take a look.
There are 3 things we've learned about Tecmo's Team Ninja after taking a look at their latest offering, Dead or Alive 3. First is that after developing DOA and DOA 2, these guys have polished the mechanics of their fighting game to near perfection.
Second, DOA 3 does look incredible.
Xbox well enough to milk the hardware for all its worth, using bump mapping, high-res textures, and other tricks to create unmatched visuals. Third, those boys at Team Ninja didn't really date much in high school. but we won't hold that against them. With DOA3, they're treating you to 16 distinct fighters, each with his or her own unique fighting styles. The strengths and weaknesses of each style are represented through a fighting system with heavy emphasis on...
This isn't a DOA3 ad. This is a new DOA volleyball.
Knowing when to counter and knowing when to strike is key. You're given 14 different stages to fight in, such as a serene forest, a picturesque beach, and a gritty caged arena. Four of these levels are multi-tiered, meaning you can actually knock off your opponent or be knocked off by your opponent from one level and fall to another below it. Those boys at team.
I also once tried to download DOA Extreme 1 on Xbox, but I unknowingly downloaded a nude mod patch of it, and I deleted it out of embarrassment. That was barely about DOA Extreme Volleyball. That was literally just Mexalt and Mitsu Xbox.com. Oh, this like really basic lounge drum and bass beat. Yeah, we'll check out the Halo cheats in a moment. Bodily need the Xbox beanie. Just the same one we've already seen.
I just got into Xbox Live.
It is Dark Master.
I have this really great high-speed connection, and I was playing one-on-one NFL Fever against some other players from around the country. Now my gamer tag, my online ID is
Dark Master.
I was masking my voice. You can use your real voice, or you can pick from a list of voices. I was just being friendly. I mean, I'm not one of those game guys that gets, like, totally absorbed, you know?
Taste it! Yeah!
You're going down!
That's gotta hurt.
You want some more? Oh, you like that, do you?
Watch me go! Oh, yeah! Everybody goes down!
Yeah!
So pretty soon, I had, like, the highest score...
Taco Bell Cup. The ancient Taco Bell cup with that weird ass font.
Person that was above me. I mean, hey, it was no big deal.
Oh, I don't think so.
So I decided it'd be fun to contact this guy and challenge him.
All right, how about it, Crusher?
Greetings, Fartmaster. I'm Crusher.
Fartmaster.
Crusher.
The kick is away and the game is on. He made it into the end zone for a touchdown.
It's so cheap.
Your puny efforts amuse me, Porkmaster.
What is that energy drink, Ken? Yeah, I want to see if I can find this guy's, like, acting profile or something. He's still acting or whatever.
I think I lost the football game.
How about a different game, homeboy?
Well, anyway, one of us suggested playing a different game.
Think you can cap my flag?
Bring it on, Dark Dad.
Think you can cap my flag?
And that some friends that I met online...
Balls can bottles, though.
You see, Xbox Live has this Optimatch feature, lets you easily find players all over the country who like the same games and levels.
I got some boys here who'll make you wish you were never born. I've got Arctic Avenger.
Dark Master is in trouble.
Buffalo Soldier.
Oh, Dark Master Man.
.com.
I'm a Dark Master.
And oh, that's, Giant.
What? Wake up!
Something.
All right.
A little bit of racism.
Whoa,
He's from San Francisco. He's not even from Japan.
Alright, Buffalo Soldier, cover me.
Red flag taken, red flag return. Rampage.
Arctic, look out.
Xbox Live, where you can go and interact with every stereotype of person. Let's go.
We just barely lost. I think I just got tired, and I had an exam the next day I was busy thinking about. It was all right, though. It wasn't like I was all distraught or anything about losing, you know?
Why?
I mean, it would have been nice to have
won. I love this.
But, hey, you win some, you lose some.
This is infinitely better than the other one.
I don't know much about all that, but as long as you can fit into that chicken suit, the job is yours.
Good. Good for him. Look at the and finally last, obviously. A Shenmue 2 ad. Oh my god, yeah, we had that commercial on the TV at work, like last year. Yeah, we had that in rotation. It was always fun.
You must not succumb to the evil path.
I shall take your power for the Geo.
I have played a couple hours of Shenmue 2. It was literally just lucky hit. My roommate was playing through the game, and then the three of us were hanging out in the living room one night, and we played lucky hit for like 2.5 hours. It was a good time. I'd do it again. Oh, it's G4's Halo cheats. This is the Halo 2 reveal trailer, which I'm sure you've seen. I kind of screened the Halo 2 stuff before I put it on stream, because, like, if it's the same shit you've seen 10,000 times, that's not really interesting or worth looking at, but...
If you played Halo for the Xbox, you know how realistic this first-person shooter plays. For little lizard aliens, those Covenant enemies are smart enough to dodge, hide, and snipe you like pros. Even the vehicles in the game feature realistic physics, which is where the fun starts.
Let's hold the hydrate again.
Ever knows how the game's...
You're, like, on the ball with these hydrate time cooldowns.
Explosions? Well, we're about to show you how to have some fun with some explosives and an expensive piece of military machinery.
Oh, it's going to be the Warthog flip.
Warthog jump from the safety of your couch.
Halo quickly became the Uber game to play in the new Xbox system. Its intense action, movie-styled storyline, intense visuals, and realistic physics made for some incredible gameplay. Those physics in the game have given gamers a secret, which the game designers may or may not have known would happen.
They milked the shit out of this Warthog flip.
This phenomenon is what has been named...
This is the third... This is the third disc that's featured it, I'm pretty sure, right?
...Halo gamer named Randall Glass. Randall's Warthog jump, a Halo physics experiment, has achieved its own 15 minutes of fame as a highly downloaded internet clip.
Highly downloaded internet clip.
The idea is simple, but a bit time-consuming. The effect, though, is amazing, and oftentimes quite hilarious. Start by going to level 4, the silent cartographer.
This is like such a bygone era of games where, like,
your own teammates. When you do, they will often
they would, like,
the trick is to keep these grenades close to each other when they drop them. After you have a group of
I also didn't, okay, for one thing, I didn't really realize until watching this that grenades on the ground would blow up if a grenade blew up next to them.
All you have to do is set off a chain reaction from the drop grenades and
I don't think that happens in multiplayer. It's such a bygone era, because, like, you know, this kind of thing is, like, you would see it on social media day one, and then everybody would be, like, old news. But because the internet was such a, like, not everybody had internet, not all people used it, not all people knew how to use it like that, it was just, like, this was insane and, like, really funny every time you saw it, because you didn't see people doing it every day on social media the first day that the game was out, you know?
You might be wondering how to get on top of the mountain.
I kind of miss that, like, era of just not having every piece of information at the video about video games, like, at my fingertips all the time. I kind of miss it. I know that sounds very, like, silly to say, but I don't know. It feels like stuff is a little bit less special now, you know? Like, you don't get that sort of, like, unbelievable revelation from watching videos of people breaking video games the way that you did 20 years ago, or 15 years ago, even.
If you want to be known around your block as a Halo master, then you're gonna have to beat the game on the hardest level of difficulty.
Is this gonna be the same thing?
Like the name says, you're gonna have to play like a champion if you're gonna get through the game in this mode. But we've got some tips on this difficult level that even a Master Chief could use. Xbox gamers who have played Halo know that the game isn't easy, even when it's set on easy. Of the four levels in the game, the hardest by far is Legendary. This difficulty setting is bound to give even the most battle-hardened space combat veterans a tough bit of gaming.
We're coming in too fast!
We may have discovered a secret of sorts to getting through one of the early choke points in the Legendary level. It may seem a bit cowardly, especially considering the in-your-face
Wait.
Action of this game.
Who's Hold on, is it just going to be to walk away from the first encounter on Halo?
To victory against the Covenant, then it's okay with us.
Warning, I've detected multiple Covenant dropships on approach.
On the second level, when you and the survivors of the Pillar of Autumn have crash-landed on Halo, you are faced with an overwhelming horde of Covenant troops. Now, you can do what any Master Chief worthy of his MA5B rifle would do to those slimy aliens. And probably get yourself filled with alien weapons discharge. Or you could try this new cheat tactic and save some ammo and quite possibly some frustration. On this level, at least.
Alert! Covenant dropship inbound. They must be looking for survivors. I recommend immediate evasion.
Thank you, Cortana. We're going to do just that. Duck inside this bunker and just hang out. You'll hear the sounds of grunting aliens outside. But don't be tempted to peek out and engage them. The trick here is in the music cues. You should be hearing this level's familiar battle hymn. The music swells as it reaches a crescendo before recycling and starting over. This is what to listen for. After you hear the crescendo a third time, you should hear the cavalry arrive.
You don't even have to do this. Like, if you really want to skip this combat encounter, you can just walk away. You can just keep walking towards the cave. You won't have the warthog, but you don't really need it.
Once the dropship sequence begins, you are safe to leave the bunker and make for the warthog.
The cavalry has arrived. Good to see you, sir.
This cheat is just don't play the game for a few minutes. Yeah, that's. All right. G4 was not good. Let's look at the G4 E3 trailer. Like, I'm nostalgic as shit for G4, don't get me wrong, but their actual, like, content wasn't great.
The world of interactive entertainment. I'm Ronnie Lynn Riley.
And I'm Jim Downs. The biggest video game show in the world is over, but we've got the hidden gems and surefire hits of E3. Microsoft went all out with a huge press event, an enormous booth, and a giant party. But while the show floor was filled with dozens of new titles, the real show stealers were hidden away in a secret section of the convention center. That's where Peter Molyneux was unveiling his latest Xbox titles, Project Ego and BC. Molyneux is famous for creating games like Populous and Black.
Yeah, a lot of shit like G4 and like even like a lot of early YouTube channels, they kind of just got by because they were the only ones with the equipment and ideas to do these things, even if they weren't ultimately very good at it.
Because we're dealing with someone's life. And so the idea that he gets old.
But hey, there's an Xbox debug kit on the shelf behind him.
On his face, we also keep track of just amazing details like how much sun is hitting his skin. When he's younger, that he develops a tan. As he gets older, he'll actually get more wrinkles because he's had more sun on his face. It's a puzzle game that is set in.
Yeah, I'm not. Is this?
At the start of the game, you've got these pathetic human beings that are going to die out because they're dumb. There's the two hunters that we sent out.
Yeah, I don't think this happened. I don't think this is an actual game. Was this a canceled game, or is this a tech demo that they pitched as a game and then just didn't work on the same way with as they did with fucking all the 360 era shit? Yeah.
have to wonder if it was ever an actual planned video game or just more Peter Molyneux smoking mirrors. Neat. That's all cool. Is that the Mortal Kombat? It just says Mortal Kombat now. Is that a trailer for a Mortal Kombat game or is it the movie? Deadly Alliance, okay. Look at the end finally and we'll move on to demos. Oh, there's some more of that good music. Oh, the credits aren't as cool as the OXM discs. There were more movies, Badger. There were movies in the 2000s. Fun. Got the extras. Ah, more DOA 3 costumes. I don't know if it's the same ones. Project Gotham. Content of some variety. Oh, hold on. This is a Project Gotham, like, fully unlocked save game. Project Gotham Profile. It's not Project Gotham Racing 2, this is probably... It's probably some sort of, like, ghosts. It's probably a bunch of ghosts and stuff. If that's a... Oh, it's actually named a Deadmau5 song. If that's a, Profile. So did they just like copy the dude's save game to put it on the so they could like because he was good at Project Gotham and wanted to like to help up his ghosts? That's actually a pretty cool idea. I like that. Yeah, this is just a bunch of like actual complete save games for Rally Sport and Project Gotham. That's I've never seen them do that. That's kind of nuts. All right, Halo demo again. Madden 03, NFL Fever 03, which is very funny that they were coexisting on the same disc. Panzer Dragoon, Quantum Redshift, Splinter Cell 1, Time Splitters 2, Toe Jam and Earl 3, and Whacked. I would like to check out, we'll check out Panzer Dragoon. I also want to check out Quantum Redshift, because I've seen this game in stores, I've never purchased it, I've never played it, I know nothing about it, other than that it's some sort of racing game. Oh, it's the Matrix anniversary? If I had known that, I would have allotted a little more time, we would have checked out the Matrix. I have a disc on one of these discs has an Enter the Matrix demo on it. That'd be cool. I also have an Enter the Matrix issue of OXM, but I do not have that with me. Fatal Inertia, that was a 360 game, wasn't it? Yeah, the vibes on these trailers, if nothing else, the vibes are incredible. Hey, Ocelot. Yeah, ping me on Discord and I'll fix it after the stream. I didn't realize that that wasn't working properly. It's supposed to be given that automatically, but it breaks constantly. And the same goes for anyone else. If you sub to Patreon and you have problems with it, feel free to just give a ping to me or any of the moderators and they can sort it out. What a fucking haircut, man. On amateur, I've never played this game. Trent Reznor, don't, no, that did not look like Trent, it looked like Trent Reznor, fuck! Yeah, two people said that in different chats to even. That's, yeah, I gotta, okay, fine. Looks a little bit like Trent Reznor. Wow, this is annoying, like the beeping noise on the loading screen. I think that would get annoying very quickly. First impressions, very weird sideways inertia. Like a lot more sideways inertia than you'd expect. The ads for the Xbox on the side. I wonder if those are in the final game. Mega up. A sizable retro OG Xbox market. Hey, that's the future we deserve to live in. We deserve to live in a future where everybody still plays Xbox, like OG Xbox. Look, it's this weird, like castle. Like the other character was a prince. So it's like this weird, like, sci-fi future, but like still has like kingdoms and shit, castles. Replay. Let's see the replay system. Oh, the character model in the car. Oh, that's very silly looking. One AI was just leagues ahead of everybody else. Yeah, the explosion sound effect is not great, and then also it's way louder than it should be, even at a distance. I mean, this looks cool though. Like the replay system isn't that bad. Is this the only race in the demo? I think I only get one track. Yeah, only one track. It's kind of disappointing. I think for a demo you paid some portion of $8 for. Would pay a little bit more. Panzer Dragoon Orta. Harley wanted to see this one. And I've actually never played a Panzer Dragoon game. So, I'm interested. Maybe I've played a little bit of Orta. I might be wrong. Smile a bit. Panzer Dragoon was a Sega franchise. Dragon Control. Very Japanese. Okay, I guess we'll figure it out. I guess a simple way to describe Panzer Dragoon would be if you've played Rez, that, but dragons. If you've not played Rez, probably the closest thing you've probably played is, you know that level in Sonic Adventure where you fly to the egg carrier on the plane and you have to do it twice because that happens twice in the story? Yeah, it's that. Very impressive looking for the 2002, you know? Like, it's neat. Am I able to turn around? Doesn't look like I am. I'm being shot at from behind. Oh, it's the triggers, okay. White flashes are you talking about? Oh, I see. Yeah, it's a staple of Japanese rail shooters. Like, it's... I'm pretty sure that's because light guns needed that to function. But then maybe when they were making other rail shooters, they just kind of kept it in as a holdover. Was the source to RPG Lost, like the Lost Sega stuff there in the era? Who knows? Only they know, I guess, unless they've announced something about that. Yeah, the white flash, yeah, that actually is getting really irritating when it's like the random full screen ones. And nothing's even happening. Like, I'm not doing anything when that happens. I don't know, I feel like that's something that would be in this game. Because, like, sometimes the flashing is coinciding with something. I think it actually might be the lightning. Might be how they're doing the lightning. Yeah, this isn't as cool as I thought it was going to be. Maybe there's a lot more context or flavor to it. On their consoles, it's like the soundscape is very barren. I say that, then that starts happening. That's not better. Yeah, I think it was the lightning. Because we're in here and it's not happening anymore. There's a fuck ton of reverb for no. I mean, I guess we're in a cave, but like, the reverb doesn't sound good. Yeah, that's a. Oh, didn't mean to skip that. I guess I was trying to pause the demo, but didn't once we were entering our cutscene. Some sort of boss fight type deal. Good old Japanese thing flashes rapidly to indicate it's taking damage. The egg carrier! Yeah, I guess I never really realized that Sonic Adventure level is just straight up Panzer Dragoon, huh? Yeah, I just think the tone and setting isn't really doing it for me personally, but I see why people like this. It's definitely like a chill, press buttons and flourishing it. Was there not voice acting? Oh, I can't walk onto these. Yeah, I have to wonder if there's supposed to be voice acting, even if it's in a made-up language, like the other chat's saying. Yeah, I think I'm good on this. I understand the appeal, this is just the same for me. I'll stick to Rez, thanks. Okay, I say we play one more demo and finish it out. We got Splinter Cell, we got Time Splitters 2, Whacked, Toe Jam and Earl. I think Time Splitters 2 would be a fun one. Never actually played that game. And Splinter Cell for some folks. I know someone else said they wanted to see the Splinter Cell demo earlier as well. How do y'all feel? YouTube chat. Yes, I've played Time Slayer's Future Perfect. I've just not played 2. Yeah, I actually, when I first got my OG Xbox again in 2017, I bought a sealed copy of Time Slayer's Future Perfect for $17.99. Opened it, which is kind of regrettable in retrospect. But I played through that game in like 2 sittings. So that was fun. Time Slayer's Splinter Cell. Okay. People seem they're cool with Splinter Cell. Let's go with that. I have played this game for a bit on PC. I've never gotten very far on the Xbox version because there's no quick saving, but... I mean, I definitely did buy this for this off-mount exploit. Okay, interesting title screen. That's different, I think. Oh.
Bishop, the sun's down. Time to go to work. Binding Agent Blaustein's our first priority. Last active position was in a police station. Check your hotsat.
I'm on my way.
Put that down. Put that down. There we go. Okay, guess the door's locked. Maybe it's from how I got to this area in the real game, but because it's the demo. Yeah, I love the Splinter Cell games. I've played all of them to some degree. Chaos Theory is the only of the OG trilogy that I've beaten. I have a soft spot for Conviction, I know, as well, which I know is kind of a crime, but... Okay. Don't know how to... leave. Oh, okay, the door works now, I guess. Oh, I remember this hallway. I'm not gonna take the gun out. No. The fuck?
Who in the hell are you, supposed to be?
Oh, yeah, I remember this little, this, like, tension music. You gonna fuck off, bud? Reload. Yeah. Your footsteps over there. Yeah, I cannot imagine these games running great on PS2. I mean, you see, it's not exactly steady on Xbox. Correct? I don't remember that happening on PC. I do remember this level though, this area.
I heard something move.
No, you didn't. Oh, fuck. What the fuck? Okay. Yeah.
Damn. You know you just gunned down a civilian, right? One more mistake like that and this mission's finished.
Silly Fisher, don't do that again. Don't kill civilians. Yeah, I don't know if I have the patience to play this properly right now, I'm gonna be real, but, always interesting to see what they pick for the vertical slice. Fucked up. Don't come down here, please.
Must have been nothing.
Yeah, entirely possible, I guess. I don't think that it has guess maybe those other menus are closed. Also, I just noticed that it's a fucking Palm sponsored. That's interesting. Okay, let me out. How the fuck do I leave this menu? I was pressing the same things I was already pressing to close it before, and that kept opening the controller menu. Alright, well. very Y2K-ass computer room. Can I close the door?
Hey, I'm in here.
Are you? You aren't. Uh-oh. No way I got away with that. How did I get away with that? Here, I probably shook him out. What's the button to shook someone out from behind? Don't know. Can you shook someone out from behind in this game?
Heard something.
No. Heard nothing. No! Ah, oh, fuck. I like that the like the tension noise when you die is the same thing as the start of that Mindfield song from The Matrix. Yeah. Anyways. That's Splinter Cell, the demo. That man is holding... Okay, he is holding a gun. I thought it was an air gun. Yeah. Coming soon. This wasn't even out yet. That's neat. Yeah, that's cool. This is a fun stream. I really enjoyed going through these. Lots of cool stuff. I think, honestly, even more than the demos, I think what I enjoyed most out of this was watching all of the really antiquated trailers and, like, the informational videos about Xbox Live, you know? Such a new technology at the time that they were getting to show off, so... That was really fun. And we will be doing more of this. I have a ton more OG Xbox demo discs to go through. Given that we've done a few today, next time I'll probably vet them a little bit more myself off stream, rather than letting it be a surprise, just so I'm showing off cool stuff that we haven't seen. Yeah, I think next time we do something, it's almost definitely gonna be PlayStation 3 stuff. I've not tried out the Windows Media Player skin yet, because... I've really not been doing much at my computer besides working on videos and occasionally playing Halo, because I've been working a lot and stuff like that. But I do appreciate you sending that my way, and I'm definitely gonna get it set up one of these days. I need to set up my XP machine. I need to get that a little bit. I need to clean it up a little bit and get it set up. And when I do that, it's something to go on there. That Xbox soundtrack CD that I have that I mentioned earlier has some Windows XP stuff that I really want to show off in a stream sometime. So maybe I'll either get a good VM set up with a bunch of fun stuff like that, or I'll get my real PC set up and hooked up and captured on all that. But one of these days you'll see it in a stream, almost certainly. But yeah, I hope y'all enjoyed as much as I did, and thanks for you, the ones that stuck around. Go play your Xboxes. Cherish them while they still work. Yeah. I'm gonna go get some food in me. But I hope y'all have a wonderful evening, and thank you for watching.